was there? Who has dared enter my domain? A mortal. Well, isn't this interesting? Why ever have you come? Why are you here? Mortals such as yourself, you do not belong here. This place, this house, is incredibly dangerous. So why have you come here? Oh, dear human, I assure you, this is not a hallucination, nor is it a prank. Undoubtedly, I am a real ghost. I am your worst nightmare. No matter what you do, you cannot hurt me. You cannot defend yourself against me. You cannot touch me, but I can touch you. That is the power of the ghost. I am far superior to you, human. I have lived a mortal life. I have been through all that you have. And I have been through death. I understand hardships. And I understand fear. Human, your face has grown awfully pale, hasn't it? Are you afraid? Are you petrified? You cannot hide it from me. The circles under your eyes, the shakes in your hands and legs, I can see it as clear as day. You are terrified. Blame you. Who wouldn't be terrified of this? Oh, human. You have no one to blame but yourself. You are the one that walked into my domain. And now, you are the one who will be trapped here forever. With me. Did you really think I was going to let you leave? To bear witness to my beauty and walk out so casually? I would be a fool for allowing you to leave, human. And I am no fool. You are the fool. You are the one who came here. You are the one who did not listen to the chills along your spine. The warnings. How could one be so foolish as to come? Now you will face the consequences. You may be rather sad about this, As for me, I will no longer be lonely. I have you to entertain me, mortal. I'm so happy you're here. Now you're under my command. What I say is what you'll do. Like a clown for the circus, my little jester. Oh, human, how cute you are. So naive, so innocent. Since this will be a forever home, I wonder where I should keep you. Should I give you your own room? Should I give you your own bed? Or perhaps I should make you sleep on the floor like a dog? Do you know? You are so entertaining. Come now, follow me. I will bring you to your stay. This is where I stay, and this is where you will be staying. The room is rather dusty, isn't it? I would apologize if I felt bad, but dust does not concern me. After all, I do not have lungs to breathe it in. Perhaps the dust will be a little more of an issue to you. And if you have a problem, you will clean it up yourself. I am not here to take care of you. And I am not asking or telling you to take care of me. I suppose I should establish these roles. You are my pet. Did you hear me? You are my pet. Until the day you die. Doesn't that sound lovely? I'd like to try and see you have any objections. What are you going to do? Run away. You fool. There's no escape. You're here with me forever. You're mine. Oh, woe me. Why ever would you cry about it? You're the one who trespassed into my haunted house. You put yourself in this position. I did nothing. I did not force you to come in here. So what use is there in being upset with me? You have no one to blame. Now then, I've been rather bored for so many centuries. I think it's time you entertain me. I've long forgotten what a human feels like. So come here. Come here now and lay down. Mind the dust. There you go. Get nice and comfortable. Are you all relaxed now? Laid in the bed. You may already know this, but I will warn you anyways. When I come into contact with you, it will feel like a cold breeze. I do not have body temperature like you do, mortal. It may not feel the most pleasant, but we are here for me, not for you. Human, how warm your skin is. Oh, it's so pleasant. It's been so very long since I've touched a human. I can't believe you radiate warmth. It's wonderful. And your hair is so soft, too. And you breathe. And you have a beating heart. Ba-dump. Ba-dump, ba-dump, ba-dump. Ba-dump, 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 ba-dump. Human, how wonderful it is you are alive. You are making me a truly happy ghost. And you have fingers and arms and legs. Oh, a neck. Isn't that so fascinating? And real eyes, and a real nose, and a real mouth. One ear, two ears, oh my. How marvelous. I cannot see myself in the mirror. I have nearly forgotten what a human looks like. So fascinating. One eye. Two. Truly spectacular. Boo-tacular. A little bit of ghost humor. Would you like to hear another ghost joke? I've come up with quite a lot in my eternity. Do you like jokes? I sure hope you do. Sure hope you boo. What does a ghost unlock a door with? A spooky. Where do ghosts buy their clothes? Out of boutique. Oh, I love this one. Why do ghosts love elevators? It lifts their spirits. Oh, aren't jokes so lovely? Would you like to hear another one? Didn't the ghost eat her candy? She didn't have the stomach for it. Get it? Because I do not have a stomach, and I cannot eat. Oh, jokes are so funny. I bet you don't have any clever jokes to tell me, do you? Well, if you could tell me a joke, I would like you much more. No, I do not want to hear it. Don't even try to tell me one of your jokes. I'm sure it will be dreadful, and it will spoil my ghostly appetite. So, keep your poor jokes to yourself. I'd prefer if you sat quiet and let me have my fun. Do you understand? Good. Just I'm so happy you're here. I've been alone for centuries, waiting and waiting, waiting days and nights, trapped between the walls of my own ghostly home. No one to keep me company. trying to keep myself entertained. Creating my own melodies against the glass. Let me ask you, human, why is it that you came here alone? Why is it you are not accompanied by friends? Are you lonely, human? Do you have no one? How pathetic. But don't worry. You are not alone any longer. After all, you're trapped here with me now. And you'll never have to return to that pitiful existence. Make me feel a little better, knowing that you were lonely too. Now we have something to relate to, something in common. And perhaps your lonely life will make you more attached to me. Isn't that? I would offer you comfort. I would offer you to lay your head in my lap. But I fear you would simply phase through me. And it would make your head rather cold. But not to worry. I simply wish to run my fingers through your. It's just been so long since I've seen human hair. So wonderful. You are my mortal. You are mine. You belong to me. You belong to a ghost for the rest of eternity. And I centuries. accidentally hurt you. I'm sorry. I apologize. It's been so long since I've come into contact with anyone. I greatly underestimate my strength. I did not mean to hurt you. I will be more careful next time. And I will not hurt you again. Not on purpose, at least. I know I am rather intimidating. And rather mean. But I only act such a way because I am so much more superior than you. It's only fitting I look down upon you. But that does not mean I hate you or want to hurt you. You don't have. Even if you're scared now, I promise, when you spend enough time with me, when you spend enough time in my care, you will eventually grow to love my presence, my company. Who wouldn't enjoy this after all? I am a wonderful companion, am I not? Here, let me give you more head pats and play with your hair a little bit more. What a good pet. Isn't it amazing how you are alive and how your fragile human heart is pumping blood through your body? I think that's wonderful. So. Such a wonderful heartbeat. Ba-dum, 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 ba-dum. So.